300. Now fight week, media underway. How exactly are you feeling about this opportunity in front of you?
Thank you. Yeah, I feel great. I'm excited. You know, I've always taken big risks in my career, and this is the biggest. And you know, UFC 300 versus Holly Holm, new weight class, new promotion, legend of the sport. I'm all in. I'm excited.
You mentioned the weight class. I feel like probably everywhere you go this week, people are saying, how's your weight? How's your weight? How's your weight?
I know.
So how is your weight?
Do I need to flex on oil? No, I'm just kidding. My weight's good. Everything's dialed in. I have a superb team behind me. Eric Pena, the UFC PI, has been helping out. My chef and nutritionist, Dara, has been making ridiculously delicious meals. So I've been disciplined, I've been dedicated, and it's going to show.
Yeah, we hear fighters sometimes say, oh, that's the battle before the battle, right? Cutting the weight. For you, obviously, it is a new weight class. Do you almost feel like once you've got those scales, it's like just time to have fun at that point? Then it's fight night, you can put on the show and get the job done.
I mean, I'm already having fun. You know, like this is the hay's in the barn, the work is done. I get to do this. This is a thing that I chose to do. Like, I'm not sitting behind a desk, I'm not, you know, I don't know, a nurse, I'm not a doctor, I'm not a lawyer. This is my job. I'm a fighter. This is what I chose to do, and I'm very blessed to do it. And even the shitty parts, you know, it's all a part of the journey, and it's all shaping me, molding me, and forming me into the best version of myself. So this is all fun for me.
And for Holly Holm, what do we think of her as the opponent welcoming you to this new promotion?
Yeah, I mean, I think she's... I don't say legend lightly. You know, I think that it takes a special kind of person to be a UFC champion, to be in the top 10 for so long, to stay relevant and to evolve as much as she's evolved. She has a super high fight IQ. She's got excellent footwork. We know that she has a striking background, but she's evolved into a very well-rounded mixed martial artist, and I think she's probably the toughest test in the division for me, so.
Yeah, right here. Obviously, there are fight fans that only watch the UFC. They don't really watch other promotions. So I'm curious, have you noticed that a lot of fans already knew who you were, or have you had to kind of introduce yourselves to fans or anything like that?
I think it's a mixture of both. There's been a lot of warm welcoming, and a lot of people have shown me a lot of love, and a lot of people are like, who the fuck is that guy? So. It is what it is.
What do you make of this UFC bantamweight division? Because obviously in PFL, this wasn't your division, like you said. How closely did you follow the UFC, this division specifically?
I mean, I watched. I'm not gonna lie to you. I'm not a avid watcher. Like, if I'm not in the fight or if it's not a fight that interests me, I probably don't turn the fights on just because I got two kids and I'm in bed at like 9 p.m. every night. But I watch the division. I've been taking notice. I've been keeping my eye on the pulse, and they need a new queen.
Well, kind of going off of that, you know, Laura Sanko has said, like, you were what the women's division kind of needed, something like this. So do you kind of feel like, do you agree with that? Like, the type of fighter like you that is also can speak on the mic and fight like you do is what this division needed?
Yeah. I mean, I think that, thank you, Laura. I agree 100%. I concur. Court is now in session, the queen has arrived, and Saturday night's gonna be, yeah, my coming out party. Everyone's gonna be put on notice.
So were you already planting the seeds with Rocky, you know, you kind of guys were tweeting back?
I get it. Look, I get it. If I were Rocky, I'd fight, what's her face, Juliana too. Yeah, of course I'd be calling for that fight.
And there's two last questions for me unrelated to your fight. Can I get your thoughts on the main event between Alex and Jamal and the BMF fight between Max and Justin?
Yeah. Well, I don't know Jamal super well, but I've met Alex now, and he's a terrifying individual. So, yeah, I'm excited for that one. I think they both have a lot of power, so it's going to be, you know, somebody's going out. And same with Justin and Max. I don't know Max that well, but I've known Justin actually. He was one of the first fighters I met when I signed with the World Series. And he's just crazy, like in all the best ways. You know, he's he's every fighter's like one of their favorite fighters for a reason. And Max too, he's beloved by the people and by the fighters, by all of the UFC staff. So you know he's a good human. It's hard to, you don't want anyone to lose that one almost, you know, like it just sucks. But I'm expecting fireworks.
KAyla over here. Right here, good to see you again. I was wondering, Ronda Rousey came out with the book. You obviously were on the judo team and obviously roommates. She talked about having concussions throughout her career. Were you aware of that or ever given a hint of that back when you guys were competing in around each other?
I know that she had one concussion, but that's really, I can remember one time where I think she had a concussion at a tournament in Belgium, but that's the only one I recall. I wasn't her doctor, obviously. I was 16 and trying to stay alive.
To ask you about your career, how important is it for you to get that microphone potentially after a victory and kind of let everybody know that you are that new face to watch in this promotion?
I think it's more important to get my hand raised and to focus on that for sure, but I think you guys all know by now I like to talk a little bit, so I just go with the flow. Like the adrenaline is usually pumping like so much after a fight, it's hard to shut me up. So I'm excited to go talk some shit to Joe Rogan and let him know what's up. It'll be good.
Last one. In a dream scenario, does this UFC run culminate in potentially bringing back Amanda for that big title fight?
I mean, that would be fantastic, you know? I think that, yeah, I want to fight the best. She's the GOAT for a reason, and I would love for her to come back and get pissed off enough to want to come back. So we'll see what happens, but first things first, Saturday night, Holly Holm.
KAyla, down here to your right. You gave a glowing review of Holly Holm there and her legendary status and what she's done in the sport. Are you happy to be thrown in at the deep end against such an icon of the sport so early into your career, UFC career?
Yeah, I mean, listen, I'm a veteran now, you know? I'm 17 fights in and, this is it. I don't wanna be given easy fights or like I want to get in and I want to be UFC champion by the end of the year.
KAyla over here. Okay. You're constantly being compared to Ronda Rousey and I'm wondering, is that something that you're proud of or something that kind of annoys you or maybe a little mix of both?
Look, Ronda is a pioneer in this sport. She's the whole reason I'm sitting here today. So I'm not gonna take knocks at her or be insulted by it. I think the hardest part is that I'm my own person, right? Like, I don't know. I'm my own person, so we're just different. But I have a lot of respect for her, and I'm grateful for everything she was able to accomplish in this sport and to help grow it for women and shatter ceilings. And now my job is to stand on top of her shoulders and continue to do that.
Hey, KAyla over here. So you are winner of Judo 2015 in Georgia, Tbilisi. Actually, can you talk about your transition, how it works on you, like from Judo to go in MMA?
Yeah, it was a big transition, you know, to go from just being thrown and to getting punched in the face is kind of it's a big change really fast. But to be honest with you, I love it. I loved everything about it. Being an expert at something, but a beginner all over again, and having to figure out a way to make those two come together was why I loved MMA. And I'm still learning every day, still growing, still getting better, still making changes and adapting and growing. So I always say that judo was my first love, but MMA is my real love.
And last one, what's your opinion about Georgian judokas?
Oh my god, they're beasts. I love the Georgian team. They're awesome. I remember when I won the Georgian, the Grand Prix or World Cup, I can't remember what it was, in Tbilisi.
Yes.
There's a little boy, Nico Miko, maybe. I gave him my trophy. I want to find out if he's still doing judo, because it was my tradition to always give my flowers and my trophy to a child in the crowd. So I want to know if he's still doing judo. But all the Georgian guys are like, Lipertiliani, he's probably my favorite Georgian judoka. Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Kayla, right here.
What up, Mike?
Not too much. Your manager, Ali, had an interesting quote this week where talking about your star power. Yeah, he said you could be Ronda Rousey on steroids, maybe not the best choice of words.
Thanks, Ali. Yeah.
The sentiment behind that comment, though, like in terms of your star power, do you kind of agree you can take things to another level here if you do the run you want to?
I hope so. I mean, that's the goal. I'm not comparing myself to anyone or anything. I'm my own person. I have my own path. I just try and keep walking it every day, one foot in front of the other. And the goal is not to be, I mean, look, of course everyone wants to be a star. The goal is not to be a star. The goal is to be a UFC champion and be so fucking good you can't ignore me. And then to use this platform to change the world how I want to, you know? Like, there's steps to it. And really being a star isn't a piece of it. It's something that I guess everyone wants to talk about, but I just want to be so good that you guys have no choice but to call me the queen. Okay, thanks guys.